Hey guys, this is Jen, and today I wanted to share with you my favorite MLBB lipsticks, but before we get into that, I wanted to do a little shout out to the Pet Collective channel. I'll leave a little annotation right here because I recently did a pet haul for my little puppy. We ended up naming him Oreo, so if you gave that name suggestion, let me know down in the comments. I absolutely love him. We got lots of cool stuff for him, so click over there and check out the video. But now, let's get into my favorite lipsticks. So the first lipstick I wanted to talk about is a NYX Black Label lipstick. This is an oldie but a goodie for me. I've loved this one for a long time. The shade is in Bling. As you can see, it's just this nice medium warm pink. It's on my lips right now. It's also very hydrating, so it's easy to wear on a daily basis. You don't have to be absolutely too careful and always use a mirror every time you wear it. It also leaves a nice glossy finish on the lips. It feels super, super duper moisturizing, and it smells like grape bubble gum, so that's always a bonus. The next lipstick shade I wanted to talk about is from Urban Decay. It's from their new Revolution Lipsticks line, and the shade is Fiend. The nice thing about this lipstick is it's really opaque and has a lot of creaminess to it. It's a thicker formula than some of the other more balmy lipsticks, but it's still hydrating. It doesn't dry out my lips too badly, and I just feel like it really pulls together a look. I still put it in the My Lips But Better category because it's not like a really bright shade or baby pink or anything. It's that nice middle ground pink, but it definitely still has a bit of elegance and put togetherness about it. This one is from Benefit. It's another one of my very, very favorites. Actually, at this moment, this is probably my favorite in my purse all the time MLBB. It's a little bit on the warmer side of MLBB's, plus it has a bit of a brown base, so it's a more natural color than some of the pinker shades. I think it's so hydrating, and it would be really great for school or work, somewhere where you're not going to want to attract too much attention, but it does have a great glossy finish as well. It feels so nice on the lips, and it's unscented, so it's not going to irritate those that have a more sensitive nose. The packaging is also really cute because it kind of looks like one of those old school Grecian columns or something. Maybelline's Color Whisper in Rose of Attraction is also one of my very, very favorites right now. It's nice because it's drugstore, so it's just about everywhere and it's affordable, plus it's really hydrating as well. I find this color to be a little bit brighter and pinkier, kind of a rosy tone. It's just really easy to wear and really flattering, so I've really been loving this ever since I bought it. Finally, I don't want to say I saved the best for last, but this is probably my most well-known MLBB. It's Too Faced La Creme Lipstick in Spice Spice Baby. This is a cream formula. There's no glitters or sparkles or anything in it, but it feels so plush and hydrating. It's also a little bit more on the pigmented side compared to the balmy side. This one, more than any of the others, is probably the closest to my own natural lip color because it has that great medium earthy warm pink shade to it. It's very, very natural, but still has a lot of creaminess and a lot of shine to it without being too noticeable. I just think it's a beautiful color and it feels wonderful, and I'm pretty sure every single person I've recommended it to has loved it as well. So all of these, but especially this one, are really highly recommended. So I guess that's the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed watching all of my favorite MLBBs, and I hope you guys found it helpful in case you're looking for your perfect MLBB too. There are subtle differences. They're not all the same. I kind of said the same thing in my What's in My Purse video because I'm pretty sure I had about half of these in there at the same time. If you haven't seen that one, click over here. I'll leave an annotation and you can watch that video as well. But thank you guys so much for watching. Give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed this or found it helpful, and leave a comment down below of what you would like to see in my next video. This is Jen, and I will talk to you guys next time. Bye! Hey guys, this is Jen, and today I have a date night tutorial to share with you. I'm starting the eyes by applying Trish McAvoy's Eye Base Essentials. This can be a beautiful, simple evening look. To give the lips just a little bit of extra polish, I'm adding some clear lip gloss on top. This is Brilliant from Le Métier de Beauté.